Welcome to this week's service. We're glad to have you here. This is Pentecost Sunday, the birthday of the church. So let us celebrate and join in worship. Welcome.
Good morning, and I am Pastor Pam, and I asked to share time with you this morning because this is one of my favorite stories. So we're going to start out by putting the bright red cloth down. I'm going to tell you a story about a lot of people a long time ago. They all spoke the same language. Everything they said, everybody understood. So they decided one day that they were going to build a tower to God. So they started building their tower. It got taller and taller, and they just kept building it. And they were so proud of themselves. They thought they were the greatest people. They were going to reach God all the way to heaven. And then God saw what they were doing. And God went with a giant piece of wind, whoosh, and knocked it all over. And all of a sudden, they couldn't understand one another. They were all speaking different languages, and then they scattered to all parts of the earth. In the Bible, we call that the story of the Tower of Babel. It explains why there's so many different languages in the world. Time went along. And about 2,000 years later, Jesus came. And Jesus taught people all about God's love. And Jesus, as we know and we've celebrated, died on the cross and was raised by God. And after the disciples spent some time with him, Jesus goes home to God. And so one day, right after that, the disciples decided that they needed to meet together. So they gathered in this room. We're going to build the room here for a little bit. Got to keep the door open. And all the disciples came in to the room. And they gathered in the room. And they talked about Jesus. And they talked about the promise that Jesus had, that someone special was going to come to help them. And so as they talked to one another, let's make sure I have all the disciples there, all of a sudden, a great wind came again. And the Spirit of God came on all of them. And they were touched by the Holy Spirit. And they began to praise God. And they could understand all the languages again as God gave them the gift to understand how to share His love in the world. And they didn't stay in this room. They went out to all the parts of the world to share God's love. And we remember this day as Pentecost, which means 50. 50 days after Easter, we remember the birth of the church, and we use bright red and fire to talk about the power of the Holy Spirit and how it touched each one of the disciples, just as the Spirit touches us. Thank you for listening this morning.
Thank you.
When the Pentecost day arrived, they were all together in one place.
Tout à coup, il vint du ciel un bruit comme celui d'un vent tempétueux.
Come un vento impetuoso, un rumore tale che riempì tutta la casa dove si trovavano.
Ang mga dilang kawangis ng apoy na nagkabahabahagi.
Todos ellos fueron llenos del Espíritu Santo y comenzaron a hablar en otras lenguas según el Espíritu los llevaba a expresarse. Cuando llegó el día de Pentecostés,
at nang dumating nga ang araw ng Pentecost.
Le Pentecost.
50 giorni dopo la morte di Gesù.
Di Gesù.
Di Gesù.
Today is Pentecost. The word sounds very religious and sort of foreign, but what it means is simply 50 days. Pentecost happens 50 days after Easter. And the color that we use is fiery red because fire is involved in the story of Pentecost. We celebrate it as the birthday of the church. But Pentecost has all kinds of wonderful drama in it, a lot of reflective drama from the Old Testament. You have wind and you have fire like Moses and the burning bush. You have different languages and all of a sudden people understand. It's like the reverse of the Tower of Babel. Drama speaks to us as if God's presence has finally arrived. And the scripture talks about everybody was amazed and astonished. And most of the time with the Pentecost story, we focus on the drama, and sometimes we miss some of the nuances in the story itself. We miss the idea was, is this a story of hearing or a story of understanding? Is this a story that really wants us to dwell on the what? I don't think so. I think it wants us to dwell on the results of what happened. See, the point of Pentecost is not the fire and the wind, but it's what happens to the disciples. It's that group of people who ran away on Good Friday, who hid, who then had these experiences with Jesus, and then Jesus ascends to heaven. And what are they going to do next? Through the gift of the Holy Spirit, which falls on them in a loud sound, they are moved to transform their souls and their hearts and to transform the world. So here we are at Pentecost. For thousands of years, the church has been celebrating Pentecost. But I want to share with you this morning a couple of things that I think are interesting about the gift of the Holy Spirit. And I'm going to start with a story. The story is about a synagogue in Eastern Europe. And there was a special prayer that they always prayed. And when they got to that part of the service, half of the congregation would stand and half of the congregation would sit. And the half that was standing would start yelling at those who are sitting that they should stand up. And the half that are sitting started yelling at those who were standing that they should sit down. And the rabbi just stood there all the time and shook his head. So it was suggested that maybe the rabbi visit with one of the founding members of their congregation. So the rabbi takes two people with him, one of the standers and one of the sitters, and they go to visit this older man. And as they gather, the first one says to the older man, "During our prayer, isn't it our tradition to stand during the prayer?" And the older man says, "No, that's not our tradition." So So then the persons who sit say, isn't it our tradition to sit in the prayer? And the man said, no, that's not our tradition. And the rabbi says to them, but they fight. They yell at each other to sit or stand, and the old man says out loud, now that is our tradition. One of the things that I want to say about the Holy Spirit is it doesn't come to solve our problems. The Holy Spirit doesn't solve the problems of the disciples, but it changes their hearts. If the Holy Spirit had not come, they probably would have been back to being fishermen or whatever their career was before they became disciples of Jesus. I can almost hear James and John walking back down the road going, boy, that was a crazy 3-year ride with Jesus. He taught us so many things, but I'm kind of glad we got that out of our system. The gift of the Holy Spirit says, once you have experienced it, normal is no longer an option. And that was true for the disciples. They could not go back. They could not return because they had been touched by the love of God through the gift of the Holy Spirit. Once the Spirit touches our heart, we are not the same, and that's the same for us as it was for the disciples. No amount of time that we could spend trying to figure out how to be a church substitutes for us going out into our world and saying, what do you need from us? How can we resource you? How can we share with you the love of God? Not how can we do it for you, but how can we share the love of God? Pentecost calls us to go outside our doors. It was true back then because the disciples did not stay in that room. They moved outside and they moved to the ends of the world. The second thing I think is important about the Holy Spirit is the Holy Spirit doesn't prevent us from failing. Actually, the Holy Spirit invites us to fulfillment and victory, even though we're going to have setbacks and failures. The early church struggled. They had churches that they failed to understand their opinion of one another or how they were going to get along, or should we allow this person in or that person in. They had setbacks. They had places that were failures. They did not live by the mission control statement from Apollo 13, failure is not an option. I love that statement, but it paralyzes us because failure is not only an option, it just happens in life. The problems that we face are sometimes too great, too complex, too significant that we can't imagine to hit the first solution and the best solution first time out. The lesson about the Holy Spirit for me is what an English teacher once said to me, Pam, you're going to make a mistake every day. The important part is don't make the same mistake. Every mistake, every setback, every false start is not to be lamented, but it's to be learned from. Living in our world, and I define it so many times that we are success obsessed, that we forget that God is here to partner with us, that God is here to sustain us in both our failures and our successes, that God is here to work with us as we listen to God. If the cross teaches nothing to us, it teaches us that success does not look like the world's success, and that sometimes victory comes disguised in what the world would think was defeat. The world thought the cross was defeat, and God said no to that. The question isn't, are we successful? The question is, are we faithful? And that's the power that the Holy Spirit brought to the disciples. A power of freedom to place ourselves alongside those who are most vulnerable, to take the great risks. In one sense, I think the pandemic has moved us to a new moment of Pentecost. Our church has been talking about our journey of discernment. Who are we now? Who are not who we were 20 years ago, but who are we now? We are in a moment of Pentecost in this congregation. And I believe that the Spirit of God is speaking to this congregation to be bold, to listen to one another, to talk to our neighbors, to take this opportunity of having the fire and the wind unite our souls It might mean we wander for a little while in the wilderness, but I always remember that God led everyone in the wilderness by fire, by pillars of smoke, and God will lead us into this time of Pentecost, this time of renewal. And may it be so for us. Amen. Gracious God, on this day of Pentecost, when you gave the church its birth, when the Holy Spirit came and touched the disciples to set them on fire to share your gift, I pray for your church universal that your Holy Spirit will move through us again. Your Spirit will bring healing to those who need it. Your Spirit will bring wisdom to those who need it. Your Spirit will bring new mission and insight to congregations who need it. I pray that your Spirit will touch all of our hearts, and we lift our prayers to you on this Pentecost morning. And as your sons and daughters, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.